Welcome to VBS. This is our last day. It's kind of sad, but we have one more day of fun. So let's stand and do our warm-up songs. Thank you for being here early. Since it's our last day, we're going to do two songs. Are we ready?
Two warm-ups. All right.
Two warm-up songs. Okay, get your paddles out. We're going to put them in your back pocket. We're going to do that song first. Ready? Here we go. Sing a little song for Jesus, you'll be right. Sing a little song for Jesus, you'll be right. Fooa, fooa, atina, switch. Fooa, fooa, coo-a, ho. Sing a little song to Jesus, you'll be right. Say a little prayer to Jesus, you'll be right. Say a little prayer to Jesus, you'll be right. Paddle. Fooa, fooa, atina, switch. Fooa, fooa, coo-a, ho. Say a little prayer to Jesus, you'll be right. Dance. Do a little dance for Jesus, you'll be right. Do a little dance for Jesus, you'll be right. Paddle, fooa, fooa, atina, switch, fooa, fooa, coo-a, ho. Do a little dance for Jesus, you'll be right. Shout, shout, amen, for Jesus, you'll be right.
Let's hear you shout.
Shout, amen, for Jesus, you'll be right. Fooa, fooa, atina, fooa, fooa, coo-a, ho. What was it? Shout,
amen,
for Jesus, you'll be right. Last one, super fast, end this song.
End this song for Jesus, you'll be right. End this song for Jesus, you'll be right.
Fooa, fooa, atina, fooa, fooa, coo-a, ho. End this song for Jesus, you'll be right. I think that was a little too fast.
That was perfect.
Okay. Last song for warm-ups.
I didn't do anything.
You didn't? Was it too fast?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Okay, well, let's do the next song and see if you can catch on. Bananas. Here we go. I like bananas.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, the mangoes are sweet. I like papayas.
Papayas.
But nothing can beat the sweet love of God. I was walking around circle 5 miles per hour, trying to find my way back to my heavenly Father.
The world tastes sweet.
Then it turned sour. Then I went to God and He gave me the power.
I
like bananas.
Oh, yeah.
Mangoes are sweet. I like papayas.
Papayas.
But nothing can beat the sweet love of God. That was very good. But to end our time together for warm-ups, we're going to do that super fast. Not too fast. You have to be able to say the words. Okay. We're ready? You can do it fast? You can just focus on motions. If you just want to focus on emotions, don't even say anything, that's fine. Here we go. Big breath. I like bananas. Oh, yeah, I know that mangoes are sweet. I like papayas. Papayas, but nothing can beat the sweet love of God. I was walking around circle 5 miles per hour, trying to find my way to my heavenly Father.
Well, it's sweet.
Then it's sour. Then I took God and He gave me the power. I like bananas. Oh, yeah, I know that mangoes are sweet. I like papayas. Papayas, but nothing can beat the sweet love of God. Very nice. I think you can sit down. I'm going to sit down.
Can we take a moment to say thank you to Miss Becky for all of her leading us in music this
week. You're welcome.
And to Ellie and Luke, too. So welcome to day 5 of God's Good Creation VBS. It is kind of sad today. It's our last day. Everybody say... Aww. But we're not done yet. We still got one more day of fun and learning about God's love for us and for all of creation. So, got a lot of fun activities planned for today. I want to tell you about our theme for the day. It is working together, we can change the world. Working together, we can change the world. And so today is about taking everything we've learned this week and putting it into action. But even as we do that, we remember that God is the one who is in control and not us. God helps, and we help God. God uses us to change the world, but God is the one who does the ultimate work of changing hearts and changing the world and not us. And so we're going to sing a song that reminds us of that today called He's Got the Whole World in His Hands.
He's got the whole world in His hands.
theme verse for today, you're going to hear in just a minute from Edward and his guest. It is from the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, and it talks about how all of us have different gifts, different talents that God has given us, and no matter what we're good at, God wants to use all those abilities we have to help other people. And so all of today's activities that you're going to do today at VBS are all about action and showing us how we can build others up. So we're going to do our theme song one more time, or maybe it's not the last time. I think we might do it at the end.
No, that's our last
time. Last time to do the theme song. So here's your last chance. And remember how we can see God in everything all around
us.
Oh, good job,
Billy. I'm captivated, I say it, I'm on a whole new intrigue. My space invaded, upgraded, I hear you talking to me. It's in the boom of the thunder, it's in the cool of the rain. And I'll say, I don't ever wanna get away. Tonight is beautiful, it's got my mind on you. And everywhere I turn is a reminder. I see you in everything, all day. And every beat of my heart keeps reminding me. I see you in every little thing, all day. No matter where I go, I know your love is finding me. I see you in everything. You're all up in everything. My soul's awakened, I'm taken by all the beauty you bring. You got it blaring, I'm staring, love watching you do your thing. There's no mistaking your style, no mistaking your touch. I see the grand, I see the subtle of your love. Lord, I see you in everything, all day. And every beat of my heart keeps reminding me. I see you in every little thing, all day. No matter where I go, I know your love is finding me. It's finding me in everything, all day. And every beat of my heart keeps reminding me. I see you in every little thing, all day. No matter where I go,
show us how ELCA World Hunger is putting God's love into action.
This is a special thank you to everyone who helped make this VBS possible during this hard time of Corona. Without you and your help, your diligent work, and your amazing videos, we wouldn't be able to bring the word to all these young kids. So, thank you. And a special thanks to the event organizer, Rebecca Worley, my mom, and Pastor Matt. Thanks, Matt. Hey everybody, I can't believe that today is our last day of God's good creation. I hope you all have enjoyed meeting our special guests as much as I have. I know that when we have the formless void, Chit, Cluck, and Steve, Buzz the Bee, and Blub the Fish on our side, we can't not end world hunger. Today, I have a very special guest, last, but certainly not least, Porsche the Pig. Everyone give a big round of applause to Porsche.
Hello, what a warm welcome. It's so nice to see all you fine people gathered here to welcome and admire me, Portia, the elegant pig.
You know, Porsche, I've never really thought of pigs as elegant, and I definitely never expected to see one coming in with a feather boa anytime soon. I mostly associated you all with pig pens and mud baths.
People always think of pigs as dirty because we roll in the mud to keep cool. But I don't think it's dirty. I like to think of it as a spa treatment. You people pay good money for mud baths.
Hey, don't knock it till you try it.
Yeah. Well, why should we think of our mud as any less glamorous?
I guess that's a fair point. Anyways, we have been learning about ELCA this week and what we are doing to fight world hunger. Can you tell us what pigs do to help us with that? I'm sure you're not selling spa treatments to anybody.
No, silly. Our pig spas are very exclusive. Only pigs allowed. But we like to help in more direct ways. Have you ever heard of a piggy bank?
Of course I have. You get a little bank that you put your coins in. A lot of times they're shaped like a pig, but they can really be shaped like anything. You know, we made a goat bank earlier this week.
Well, we pigs are where the piggy banks first came from.
You know, I'm a little bit confused. Am I supposed to put coins in your back? Do you eat money and save it for later? If I hold you upside down and shake you, are a couple quarters gonna come out, Porsche?
Porsche? No, use your imagination. You know how a money bank works, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, people put their money into a bank, and then it generates interest and grows. We're like an investment. People put their money into us by feeding us, caring for us, and providing us lots of good mud to roll in. And then, in exchange for the investment, we grow. A full-grown pig can be up to 200 pounds. We will sell at the market for way more than it costs to care for us. And also, a female pig, like myself, can give birth to piglets, and which also can be sold or given to friends and family. We're like saving accounts on hooves.
You know, now that I think about it, you're kind of similar to chickens or goats or bees or fish, but also not relatable at all and different in almost every single way. You animals can help out in a lot of different ways.
You know, it reminds me of a Bible verse from Paul's letter to the Ephesians. Paul said, "The gifts God gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for ministry, for building up the body of Christ." This job is the same. We build up the body of Christ, but it takes a lot of different people doing a lot of different things. There is no one-size-fits-all way to serve God. Just like there's no one-size-fits-all way to end hunger. Jesus uses us to build the kingdom, but it's not just about building. This verse tells us that it's also about building up others. Blub talked about this a little yesterday, but it's true for all of us. We are not the solution to hunger, but us partnering with our human friends is what does it. We aren't just solving for hunger. We're changing the economy of the whole family and community.
Huh. Thanks for wrapping up this week so neatly, Porsche. You know, maybe they should have hired you as an MC instead of me.
Oh, that's so nice. Don't be silly. Everyone has a role in the kingdom, and your role is to be the straight man. Every good comedian needs a good, goofy friend.
Thanks. Porsche.
Porsche. Anyway, I should get going now. It's almost time for my mid-morning roll. I like to get a good mud layer or early in the morning. It's good for your complexion, you know? Anyway, goodbye all, and have a great last day at God's good creation.
Yeah, bye, Porsche.
Bye, everyone. Goodbye. Bye.
It's too late. She didn't even get to stay to see her award. Oh, well.
I got an award? Oh, my gosh.
No, you can go.
It's a spitting image. Okay. Oh, my gosh.
You can go.
Yeah, don't worry.
It's just a piglet.
Look at me with everyone
We're
else.
Taking it down
I love it.
Bye, Porsche.
What do you mean?
Aren't you going to be late for your mud roll?
Oh, gosh, I guess.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Bye. I would love to have you.
Treat me well. Treat my picture well.
Bye, everybody. Thanks for coming to this week.
Well, thank you to Edward and Porsche, the pig. It's really, you know, it's actually kind of amazing. Porsche bears a striking resemblance to Blub the fish from yesterday. Huh. Well, in honor of Porsche, what have we added to our picture today?
A pig.
A pig!
Mud. We've got
two
little baby pigs.
Oh my goodness, two little baby pigs.
On a haystack.
On a haystack. What an awesome picture. Good job, Ellie. Thank you, Ellie, for giving us our beautiful picture this week, adding parts of God's good creation. So here it is, God's good creation. It's complete. Awesome job. Maybe you can draw your own picture of God's good creation, too. Well, I want to thank Edward and all of his guests this week. Didn't they do a great job for our skits? Absolutely. Thank you to Edward and to Rachel and Rebecca and all of those who participated in the skits this week. Well, have a great last day at God's Good Creation VBS. Remember to wear your wristband. And today's picture is a very special one. Take a picture of yourself somewhere in God's good creation. So maybe you want to go to your backyard, if you have something that represents a good piece of God's good creation in your yard or in your neighborhood, but take a picture somewhere in God's good creation so that you can post that to the Facebook page later on so you can get a point for your team. And by the way, shout out to the blue team. We didn't have a blue wristband this week when we're recording, so but blue team's awesome too, representing yellow today.
Go
so
orange.
Go pink.
We're gonna send you off to story time in just a minute. Miss Connie is back today to lead you in story time. You can get your snack ready. And what is our snack today, Ellie?
It's hockey sticks.
Hockey sticks?
No, hockey stick.
Hockey. What's a hockey stick?
It's.
What's on it?
Like, it's a chocolate covered.
It's a chocolate covered
biscuit stick.
Biscuit stick.
Oh, that sounds pretty good. So why do we have hockey sticks today?
Because for the pig, the chocolate represents mud, and then the sticks represents hay.
Oh, mud and hay! Fantastic. All right. Well, enjoy your snack. Enjoy story time. Let's pray before you go. Can you repeat after me? Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you that we got to do VBS this year.
Thank you that we got to do VBS this year.
Even though we couldn't be together.
Even though we couldn't be together.
Bless us this last day.
Bless us this last day.
In our learning and our laughing and our playing. Open our hearts.
Open our hearts.
To learn how we can work together.
To learn how we can work together.
With you.
With you.
To change the world.
To change the world.
And everybody said together,
Amen.
All right. Have a great day five at God's Good Creation VBS.
Have fun.
Hi, welcome to story time. So this is day five, and you know the drill. Get your snack. And make yourself comfortable. Find a good place to sit. You better hurry up now because I can't wait to see what's inside this box. You know, do you see the tag? It says to VBS kids from God. You know, God has given me a lot of gifts, but he has never wrapped one up before. I have a family that I'm so thankful for, a blessing from God. I have good friends. I'm healthy. I have a house to live in. All of these things are gifts from God. But this is something new. All right, let's see what's in here. I don't know. Okay. Oh, look, it's a heart. I know that's a gift. God's love for us, his faith in us, God's love. And I don't really know what all this other stuff is. Look, it's a bunch of pictures. Wait a minute. Do you remember the verse today? Today's verse? It's from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians here in the Bible. The verse today was, it was he who gave some to be apostles and some to be prophets and some to be evangelists and some to be pastors and teachers to prepare God's people for works of service so the body of Christ may be built up. So that's what this is. These are gifts that people share with us. These are gifts that people share with us. Look, it was called to be a pastor. That's Pastor Matt's gift. And we are certainly blessed to have Pastor Matt at our church. But there's a lot of other people in here too. And you know what? I think that's this part of the verse, the body of Christ. We can't really have a church with just one person. We are a body. So maybe Pastor Matt is the mouth of the body. His gift is to be our pastor, to teach us, to lead us in worship, teach us about the Bible. Can't do it alone. We have lots of people at our church that share their special gifts with us. See Miss Debbie here? And some of you might even be in this picture. Pastor Deb, or Miss Debbie is a teacher. That's her special gift. And Miss Therese and the Elmans, here they are. They've been teachers too at Vacation Bible School. You've had Miss Therese in Sunday school before as your teacher. That's her gift. Oh, look here. This is Eric Amundsen. He leads our youth, and all of these youth, Edward, Rachel, Addison, Jillian, they share their gifts with us too. The young people of our church, they raise money for world hunger. They serve us breakfast on Easter, and they serve food at other times at church. So they share their gifts as well. Who else? Oh, you might not know these people. This is Jessica Santiago, and this is Mike. Mike cleans our church, and Jessica is the office administrator. She has the gift of being organized. She can organize papers. She can do a website. She can send emails. She has special gifts, too, that she shares with our congregation. And what would worship be without music? Here we have Leslie and Roger and Tom, the worship band, for our worship music. Wonderful gifts of music and talents. Do you guys remember the bees from the other day? How all the bees in the hives had different jobs that they did that they were good at? What if Pastor Matt had to do everything all by himself? This is Marilyn And Marilyn makes bulletin boards. I'm sure you've seen her beautiful bulletin boards for every season. We are all part of the body of Christ. Here is Jesse and Pastor Matt. They're sharing their gift of music. But Jesse, you don't see him that often. But if you've been watching the services online, he shares his gift of working with the technology to tape our services and to share them online. Ah, Michelle, who plays the bells, Michelle's bells. It's amazing. That is a joyful noise when Michelle plays her bells. And here's John Lenhart. He's the president of our congregation. He has the gift of leadership. He can stand in front of everybody and run a meeting. That would make me a little nervous. That's his gift. Ah, Mr. Larry and Addison. I bet they're cooking something up, those two. Mr. Larry ushers. He's on the property team. He's painted, made repairs all around church. And he definitely has the gift of welcoming and good humor. He brings us all in. Oh, here we have folks from Trinity that are serving at the homeless shelter. They have the gift of service. They give up their time and cook the food and bring and serve at the shelter. If you think you have to be a big person or an adult to share your gifts, that wouldn't be the case. Here we have Marilyn and Andrea, and they're helping their grandma, Teresa, to distribute the Thanksgiving meal baskets. All the buns are arranged here. Over here's all the bags. There were a couple hundred of them, and they were there to hand out the dinners at Thanksgiving time. This is Edward, and of course, Edward has the gift of being Edward. You've seen him in the skits. He's shared music with us at church. Edward also serves on the church council, and he's the youngest member of the church council. Here is Savannah and Jacqueline. You've seen them dance for us. Did you know that you can dance in worship? It enhances, it makes the worship experience better. That's their gift. And they smile the whole time, sharing that with us. And Eden and Sawyer are sharing their gifts too. They are entertaining us at the Mardi Gras Festival. They made everybody smile and enjoy their dancing and the music. So I had a few pictures here. It's only a few of the members. We have a bookkeeper and a treasurer at our church. We have altar guild. They fix the altar with flowers for Easter, with the red for Pentecost, if you were watching last Sunday, two Sundays ago. So all of these people, we have ushers, people that donate their time, church council. We have the choirs and the directors. People are sharing their gifts. So when we say that Pastor Matt is maybe the mouth of the church, he might like it better if we said he was the brains, do you think? And it wouldn't be too far off, I don't think. But we are all the hands, the fingers, the stomachs. We are the legs of the church. We are all part of that body of Christ. Is there anything else in here? Oh, you won't believe this. What else is in here? You! God can use your gifts. You are a gift, and He's given you special talents to be part of the church, to be part of the service. Remember Portia, the fancy pig in the skit? You can lift people up by smiling, by singing in church, by praying, how much God loves to hear your prayers. So you are a gift to all of us. How does that work with the video? Can you see yourselves? You might have to look in the mirror. So we are all have hands that serve others. If we look at the verse again, the last part of it says, why did we get all of these gifts? It is for works of service. And our hands can serve others. Earlier this week, you remember when you studied about the loaves and the fishes? Jesus multiplied the fish. He blessed the meal. But it was the disciples who handed out the food. We are Jesus' hands. Well, kind of a mess I've made here, but I'm going to set this aside for a minute because this week we've been talking about the problem of hunger and what we can do. Pretty nice gift, huh? What we can do as people, as individuals, what you can do, and what our church does for the problem of world hunger. You can bring food to our food pantry at church. If you like to cook, maybe that's one of your gifts that God gave you. You can cook something for someone. You can share food with a friend. These are all things that you can do to lift up the body of Christ. Now, when we talk about the body of Christ, it isn't just our church. It isn't just people we know in Victorville or California or the United States. It's Christians all over the world make up the body of Christ. And even people who haven't yet learned about Jesus, they need to be lifted up too. They're part of God's good creation. And we've been talking about the animals that have helped us work with others to end the problem of hunger. And today it was the pig. Now it may seem kind of funny to you, but I really like pigs. I have a couple stuffed pigs. I have a great picture of a pig. He was smiling at me one day and I took his picture. Our church, like the bees and the fishes and the goats, our church has used pigs to help communities and to help people with the problem of hunger. And you can see here, this is a gift catalog. At Christmas time, some of us even buy some of these animals to give to people in villages that know how to work with these animals. See this girl with this little pig? He's kind of a dark pig. He's brown. A lot of the pigs we see are pink, but that's from our catalog. And here's another page from our catalog. Pigs have many ways of helping people in communities. They can use, this sounds kind of weird, okay, but they can use the poop or manure. If they dry the pig poop and mix it with dirt, it helps fertilize crops that they are growing to eat. You can breed pigs and make more little pigs, meat, and they can be sold at the market for money to buy other things that people need. There's another happy pig. That pig is smiling. And so that idea of a pig as a piggy bank, you see, when you feed the pig and treat it nicely and keep it healthy, it's a good investment with all of the things that you can get from a pig. The manure, the meat, the money. Pigs are like piggy banks on hooves. This lady right here, her name is Linz. Linz lives in Indonesia, It's right here on the globe near the equator. Lynn lives in Indonesia and she's a mom. She has 5 kids. And our church donated a pig for Lynn, and that pig had 8 piglets. Yes, 8. So she took 2 and gave to another neighbor, so her neighbor would have pigs and be able to use all the good things that you can get from a pig. And she sold 4 of the pigs. She used the money to send her kids to school. So she's using the money for education. And she kept 2, and you can guess what's going to happen after that. There's going to be more baby piglets. So this is a wonderful way that our church can help others and work with others around the world to help address that problem of hunger. So I hope that you will say a prayer with me before we go this last day. And you fold your hands. Dear Lord, we thank you for all of our gifts, all of the gifts that all of us have. Please help us to use these gifts to help others, to serve others. Dear Lord, we ask you to bless Lintz and her family and community and pigs so that they can work together and get the things that they need to help them become healthy and happy people. Dear Jesus, it's in your name that we ask these things. Amen. Thanks for participating in Vacation Bible School. Don't forget all the wonderful gifts that you have, the smiles that you give, your laughter, your song, all blessings from God. I hope you have a wonderful summer, and I can't wait to see you again soon.
We're in the pig pen.
Yes, now. This is such a great part of our farm because I love our pigs. Our pigs play a very important part in our farm. So we have 2 pigs. We have Fred and we have George. If you take a look, George is right behind you. And George is a very sweet pig.
I like
him. He loves to be a pet.
Yeah,
and if you get a really good little tickle on his stomach, he might lay down and kind of hang out with you. So this is George and we have Fred over there. Now, it is hot here in the mountains.
It is really hot.
And it's so important that we make sure that every animal has water, but our pigs especially need a bath. And hopefully we know the importance of a bath, right? So here we have our mud bath where we fill it up every day, sometimes even twice a day, if it's really hot, maybe even 3 times a day. So our pigs go and they're gonna cool off. Lori, can you tell us about that process? Why would a pig need to cool off?
Well, we don't have glands that work, like we sweat.
Yes, I'm sweating right now.
Yeah, because it's hot, but they don't. So they have to use the natural water. And so when they talk about a mud bath, this is literally a mud bath, and pigs root.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll root down there and get all the dirt and they get it all over them and it helps cool them. If you look right here at George's bath, right here, it's coated with mud. And that's how he keeps cool with that mud bath. So the water is one of the most essential things that pigs really need. They don't eat a lot of food.
No, but the cool thing, so we mentioned earlier that our pigs play an important part on our farm, and they really do. Often when we make a salad bar for one of our meals, if there's vegetables that we're not using, or if a vegetable is going towards the end of their life, we can feed them to our pigs and also some of our leftovers. We don't want to waste our food.
Ever.
We're very passionate about making sure we're not wasting our food. And so we get to give that food that we maybe would have thrown away to our pigs. And that's such an important piece to make sure that we're sustainable by feeding our pigs with that food.
And also the pigs, when I said they root, they will also, if we have bad weeds we don't like, we just let the pigs out in an area and they will literally pull the roots out of the ground, which is amazing. They're great weeders, so we like them for that. We, you know, tend to have the goats go out first, but then the pigs pull up the roots.
Yes.
So we don't have to weed.
No, we are so thankful for our pigs. So thank you for joining us.
Okay, welcome to the 5th and final day of Vacation Bible School. And today we're going to be making piggy plates. So you're going to need paper plate, some markers I have red and pink, a piece of paper to make the ears out of, and glue, and a black marker too. So the first thing you do is you're going to take your pink marker and color your plate pink. To give the piggy a face. So, piggy nose, a little red oval for the snout. Turn around it so it stands out. Oh, of course, we have to give piggy eyes, right? And then we need to make an ear. So you're going to take your piece of paper. And we're going to make a couple of triangles. And if you want, you can give the center in also. Just glue it to the plate. Now you have your piggy plate. I hope you enjoyed your week at Vacation Bible School. And God bless, and I will see you all later.
Hey girls and boys, today we're going to be playing a simpler version of Never Have I Ever. So one person's going to stay in the middle of a circle, and you're going to say something you've never done, and since if that applies to anybody around you, they have to get up and go search for another chair, while you do also. And then the last person who doesn't get a chair has to go back in the middle and replay it all over again.
I never talked to a
drone. No, you gotta take a chair. Okay, you gotta do it again.
I never noticed.
What is it? I have never been in a spaceship.
I've never ridden a motorcycle. I've never snowboarded.
I've never knowingly ate a bug.
Really?
Yeah, her with the butter.
And a snail.
Oh, I have eaten snail. Never mind, I lied. What happened?
Okay, so that's the games for today. You can modify it as many ways as you want to. You can take chairs away. You can try to have one person stand and left. You want to make sure everybody gets a chance going. Anyway, have fun with it. Use your imagination. The sky's the limit. And we will see you next year.
Stand up.
Be bold.
Be strong.
Be strong.
So make sure you take time to reflect on these questions together here at the end of a great VBS week. What was your favorite part, not just of today, but the whole week? What was your favorite part of VBS this week? What did you learn about how we can help God solve world hunger? What did you learn about how we can help God solve the problem of hunger? And how will you share what you've learned this week with others? How will you share what you've learned this week with others? Thank you for all of your contributions to our mission project this week through your offerings to that are going to be split between ELCA World Hunger, their ministry around the world, and our Luther Glen camp here in Southern California. And don't forget to post your pictures, but especially that one of God's good creation, yourself in God's good creation with your wristband to win points for your team. Don't forget to visit the Facebook page tomorrow to see the final standings to see which teams had the most pictures posted this week. A quick thank you to all of our volunteers for putting on this VBS this week. You took on this new challenge, and didn't they do an awesome job of putting together all of these videos? So thank you to Connie, to Linda, to Therese, to Katrina. Even though you couldn't be in the videos, thank you for your work. For Jesse, Kara, Jillian, and Addison, and William. To Jesse for doing all of the editing of these videos. To Edward, Rachel, and Rebecca. Rebecca, especially for all of your work getting us organized as a team to put on VBS. To Becky, to Ellie, to Luke, to Jessica in the office for your work in supporting as well. Teresa for some work behind the scenes. And to anybody I missed, thank you for your work. And to parents and grandparents for joining us this week. And thank you to you for being a part of our Vacation Bible School week this week.
And thank you to Pastor Matt for all the opening and closings and coordinating everything.
All right. You're welcome. It was fun. All right. So we are going to sing one more song. And it's the song, Hear Our Praises. It's kind of like a prayer. And so we are praising God and thanking God for everything we've learned and done together this week, joining all of God's good creation in worship.
Just this power of Jesus.
thank you for singing and dancing with us this week. Can you pray with me this time? I'll pray. You don't have to repeat after me because I want to pray God's blessing on you. So you can join me in prayer by folding your hands. Dear God, thank you for a great week of VBS. I pray for each child who has watched VBS this week and for each one of us that we would always know your great love for us in Jesus Christ our Lord, and that you would help us discover what gifts and talents and abilities you have given us so that we can share your love with others and with all the world. We thank you for a great week in God's good creation, and we ask your blessing on each one of us as this time together comes to an end. This we pray in Jesus' name, and everybody said together,
Amen.
Amen. Well, we are so glad that you could join us for God's Good Creation Vacation Bible School this year. We hope that you can join us again next year when hopefully we can all be together in person once again. Remember, God made you and all creation, and nothing could ever separate you from God's love. God has made you special with unique gifts and abilities so that when we all work together, everyone in the world will have enough to eat and all will know God's great love for us in Jesus Christ. All right. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.